Hostage situations require very delicate handling for both the victim and the police because you never know the mental state of the kidnapper and what they're ready to do if they get scared. Today we're presenting to you 10 top secret messages that were sent by hostages that actually helped save their life. Number one is the Pizza Hut rescue. Cheryl Treadway is a mother from Florida who was 25 years old when she found an ingenious way to alert the authorities that her abusive boyfriend was holding her hostage at knife point. After an argument, her boyfriend, Ethan Nickerson, held Cheryl and their three young children hostage, leaving Cheryl not only scared for herself, but also for her kids. And then she had an idea that probably saved their lives. She told Ethan to order a pizza because the kids were getting hungry. And when he agreed, she ordered a small classic pepperoni pizza and wrote this message on the note: "Please help, get 911 to me," and also 911 hostage help. The Pizza Hut employees notified the Highland County Sheriff's Office, which immediately took action, and Cheryl's adventure was over. She is definitely a woman to think out of the box. The pizza box, that is. Number two is the Blinkin' Morse. We go back to the Vietnam War for this one. Jeremiah Denton was a prisoner of war who managed to survive 7 years locked in a tiny windowless cell in Hanoi. During a TV interview, which he was forced to participate in as an American POW by his North Vietnamese captors, Jeremiah knew that he had to do something to alert the U.S. military about the conditions at the Hanoi Hilton and the other camps. So he took a chance to send a secret message, hoping his captors wouldn't recognize it for what it was: Morse code. He blinked the word torture, which was thankfully not perceived by his captors, but he managed to successfully alert U.S. intelligence, who picked up on the Morse code message. On February 12, 1973, he was released. We only hope we have even one quarter of his ingenuity if we're ever in a difficult situation. Number three is the actual message in a bottle. Imagine being abandoned by traffickers aboard a troubled boat after you've paid everything you had and you were promised a new life in the USA. We can't really imagine anything as horrible as this, but we would probably abandon all hope if something like that happened. Not for these brave migrants, though. They saw the long lines of a fishing vessel and decided to tie a bottle, which was stuffed with a plea for help, to the line. The message was clear: help, please, help us. The crew members found the bottle and the message after drawing in the lines, and the captain notified authorities on the Cocos Island National Park. The environmental group, Mar Viva, was asked to help, and they managed to tow the migrants to the island. The 40 Peruvians and 48 Ecuadorians were aboard the boat, which carried no flag, no name, or registration, and had been drifting for 3 days while waiting for help. Number four is the revenge of the label. Imagine happily buying a clothing item from Zara and then seeing this message on the label: "I made this item you're going to buy, but I didn't get paid for it." Would you keep the item or return it or ask for your money back? We're probably thinking the second. And this is what garment factory workers would want you to do, because 150 of them employed in the Bravo Texel factory in Istanbul were left unpaid when the owner disappeared and the factory shut down. We know this is not exactly a hostage situation story, but the secret message that the worker left in collaboration with the Clean Clothes campaign, which advocates against labor abuse, is just as smart as the rest of the messages on our list. Number five is the pounce of the hijacker. This is something that you would expect to see in an action-packed Hollywood movie, but it happened in real life, and we all need to applaud the pilot for his amazing skills and quick thinking. When Captain Amadou Mohamed Lamine was faced with an armed hijacker, he decided the best way to deal with this was to throw him off balance by slamming on the brakes and then abruptly accelerating when he landed the plane. The only problem was he was carrying 71 passengers he didn't want to hurt. So he alerted the passengers to be ready to pounce in French. Thankfully, the gunman didn't speak the language, so he wasn't alerted about the pilot's plan. Moreover, when the hijacker was thrown to the floor upon landing, the passengers and the crew threw boiling water from a coffee maker on the man's face and chest and then beat him into submission. We're sure this hijacker is never going to attempt anything like that again. Number six is the pizza call. another pizza-related rescue had not only made headlines but actually made it to the Super Bowl. A dispatcher wrote on a post on Reddit recounting a call that he wasn't able to forget. He wrote the following: I had a call that started out pretty dumb but was actually pretty serious. 911, what is your emergency? 123 Main Street. Okay, what's going on there? I'd like to order a pizza for delivery. Oh great, another prank call. Ma'am, you have reached 911. Yes, I know. Can I have a large with half pepperoni, half mushroom and peppers? Ma'am, I'm sorry. You know you've called 911, right? Yeah, do you know how long it'll be? Okay, ma'am, is everything okay over there? Do you have an emergency? Yes, I do. And you can't talk about it because there's someone in the room with you, correct? Yes, that's correct. Do you know how long it will be? I have an officer about a mile from your location. Are there weapons in your house? No. Can you stay on the phone with me? No. See you soon. Thanks. This chilling recount of the call went viral, and the No More organization actually made a PSA that aired on the Super Bowl with a 30-second video. Number 7 is the hidden message in a song. We know that one of the effects of listening to music is to feel relief, but one song in particular brought not only relief but also hope to those who needed it the most. In Colombia, there were policemen and soldiers who had been held captive for more than 10 years, and the only thing that the guerrillas let them do was listen to music. So DDB Colombia made a song just for them, a song that had a Morse code beat hidden in it that actually let the prisoners know how many of them had been saved and that help was coming. Number 8 is the Snapchat rescue. A 14-year-old girl has shown courage, strength, and brains when she left a message in her Snapchat, trying to alert authorities she was kidnapped. And it worked. The California girl was drugged and kidnapped by 3 men, one of whom assaulted her sexually. Even though she had no idea where she was, the brave girl went on Snapchat and typed a message that read, "Somebody help me, I'm in a random man's car, I am not in Santa Cruz, where am I?" Thankfully, because Snapchat allows users to share their location for a few hours, the victim's friends alerted police and they were able to find the girl. Number 9 is the Sydney Siege Quiet Hero. Although he was the youngest of the hostages, 19-year-old Jared Morton Hoffman managed to send secret messages to the police during the famous Lent Cafe siege in Sydney. One of his ways to give the messages was to pass cards that had hand-drawn maps of the layout of the cafe and the criminals' whereabouts under doors. Another one was to emphasize certain words during phone calls that the gunman forced him to make. Finally, he was able to muffle sounds as he helped hostages escape and then convinced the gunman that the reports about the number of escapees were wrong. A true hero. Number 10 is the note that saved her. For our last entry, we have a woman from Florida who was beaten and held hostage by her boyfriend, but managed to convince him to let her go and take the dog to the animal hospital. While she was there, she somehow alerted authorities and managed to do so by passing a handwritten note to the staff at the animal hospital that read, "Call the cops. My boyfriend is threatening me. He has a gun. Please don't let him know." The worker that received the note called the police, who arrested the boyfriend and took the brave woman to the hospital to be treated for injuries. Which one of these ingenious ways that people managed to send messages was your favorite? Do you think you could think on your feet if you ever found yourself in a similar situation? Let us know in the comments.